потрапіянішся, освободив пам'ятлив мав від своїх бол. Вже бімує, а чи я сходів, засмог негдо на брікнов. Брат єнш братра ненавиді, не заслужи свободи. Єднодноска, ласка лиді, творі сильне народи.
My first emotional contact with my father came in 1993 when I was watching some of his movies.
Yes, I watched the movie, heard this song.
And I heard that song, knowing nothing about it, not knowing one word of Czech, it hit me.
It hit me really hard.
And just grabbed me. And so subsequently I got a video of it sent to me here in Baltimore. I showed it to some Czech Americans here in Baltimore. They started seeing it. And I was amazed. And then I learned that, first of all, that when the Nazis banned the national anthem, it became the unofficial national anthem.
Uh-huh.
And when I've been among Czech American communities around the country, it's always their favorite song. Was a self-made person, had very little education. He started out as an actor, was at the National Theater. He had a career in cabaret. He wrote over 300 songs. He was in movies, including silent movies. He was an actor, director. He did a whole range of performing arts. And according to the experts who were quoted in the documentary, he was an expert in each aspect of the performing arts. The irony is, though, that he's virtually unknown outside of Czechoslovakia or down Czech Republic.
Tak jsem se poprvé setkala s Karlem Haslerem. Můj první dojem byl, že to musí být statečný nebo neopatrný člověk, když začal zpívat na veřejné místnosti svoji zakázanou píseň. Sotva byl Čech nebo Němec, který by neznal jeho jméno. Češi ho velice milovali. Byl pro ně symbolem svobody. Byl to starý revolucionář habsburských dní. Byl jeden ze zakladatelů republiky.
This is a letter that my mother wrote to me. Actually, after we had a big fight, as she tried to explain things, it was probably the greatest tragedy in Karl Hasler's life that he, the arch Czech, an enemy of the Germans, should so deeply fall in love with a woman who was considered German by the authorities. My mother was trying to keep me at that time from knowing too much and discovering things. And that's where the first time I saw photographs of him in his acting career and his films. So I knew that part, but to me he was sort of a very distant figure. So the first time I saw him move or show emotion was on a movie screen in New York in 1990, when it was an exhibit of Czech modernism. And he seemed a total stranger to me. So that's what the progression from his being a total stranger to 1993, when his song hit me. And
yeah,
that's my first emotional connection. And then I really wanted to discover who was he. And part of the challenge was also beyond his public persona, whether in a film or a song or politics, was what kind of person was he? I certainly learned he was a bit of a womanizer. Not as much as in the documentary. I think they overdid it, but when he split up with his wife, apparently he did womanize somewhat. But also, you know, what were his hobbies? What kind of friends did he have? What did he do for fun? What were his values? Now, one important value, which, and this actually interested me far more than most of his other stuff, is he was very political. And from the time, for example, he was active in the Czech independence movement in 1918.
Yes.
And he wrote songs opposing the Austro-Hungarian Empire. Then in the 20s and so on, with the Bolsheviks, he wrote songs against the Bolsheviks. And he wrote songs criticizing Czech politicians. And when it came to the Nazis, he used songs as a political vehicle. And so to me, because I'm interested in politics, I find that very interesting as a cultural expression if somebody would use songs as a political weapon.
Ale, yes. Kdybychom si dupli takhle všichni najednou, tolik kriminálů nemají.
Prosím vás, dejte si pozor na hubu. Vidíte? Protože takhle mluvili naše babičky a naši dědečkové a protože všichni tak dnes mluvíme, protože jsme se tomu naučili. Jen proto jsme si nechali všechno vzít. Jen proto nás takhle zvotročili. Dědek potrok, táta potrok, celý národ potroků. Do boje jdou za své pány, hudba hraje do kroku. Volno zprávo, řeč i statek, mocný pán jim mohl vzít. Ale svatý odkaz matek bude věčně žít.
He was arrested in September 41, I was born in November and he died in December. And also you've seen that, well, one of the things I learned through a documentary is that he was kept at the Gestapo headquarters in a cell in the basement for 3 weeks.
These were torture instruments. For instance, this jacket was filled with steel spirals.
Jakmile se všichni trochu napili, chtěli na Karlovi, aby zpíval provokativní písně. V tom okamžiku jsem byla velmi nervózní. Věděla jsem dobře, že se můžeme dostat do koncentračního tábora.
He was completely destroyed.
Do you have any idea how long my father was here?
He was here 3 weeks.
In the fall of 41, I've learned from history of Mauthausen, they instituted this new torture of the ice statue torture, where they'd give somebody a cold shower and then put them out in the cold and naked out of the cold to freeze to death. And that, by all accounts, is the way my father died. And actually, at Mauthausen, and interest of Mauthausen, there's a statue to a Soviet general who died the same way. And it's a very powerful statue because, you know, sort of the reverie of death kind of thing. To me, I can't even fathom it, what it must be like.